What a treat. He got his big break as band manager Murray in Flight of the Conchords.
Band agenda. Item one, haircut. Brett.
No, haven't had it done.
Well, get it cut. I mean, you don't hear of professional musicians with long hair.
Well, Led Zeppelin.
No, I mean a man. Needs a trim.
Yours is pretty long, Murray.
Item two, a gig. Oh, a gig. I'm going to get you guys another gig.
What do you mean another gig?
Remember the other one?
Vaguely.
Well, what about another one?
Murray, I was thinking perhaps we could do gigs at night.
No.
Yes, most bands play at night.
Not again, we've talked about this.
Most bands play at night.
It's too dangerous out there at night.
We go around walking around at night all the time.
Well, you know, anything could happen. You could get run over, pickpocketed, fall down a manhole, bump into people, murdered. Imagine that.
That shot Kiwi comedian Rhys Darby to global stardom, and now he's setting sail with a brand new show where he plays a pirate with a twist.
Blackbeard, Captain Kidd, the gentleman pirate.
Well, the first two are like very, very talented pirates.
But the last one is the scariest of them all. Instead of killing with weapons, he kills with kindness.
Oh, right, so you're the gentleman pirate then.
Well sussed!
It's called Our Flag Means Death, and to tell us more, the one and only Rhys Darby joins us in studio.
Hi!
Rhys, such a pleasure to speak to you.
You too, thanks for having me.
Of course, pleasure. This has blown my mind a little bit. Congratulations on the new series. You're playing a gentleman pirate. Where did the inspiration come from?
Real life.
Yep.
So this is based on a true story. There was this chap called Stede Bonnet over 300 years ago, right in the middle of the golden age of piracy, and he decided to become a pirate. Now, he was a wealthy landowner. He was an aristocrat, and he had everything. He lived on Barbados, and he was a great reader, and he was just bored of his life, and so he had the ultimate midlife crisis and took off.
Instead of the red Porsche sports car. Your good mate,
Taiki Waititi.
There we go. Co-stars in the project My Mistake. When you have someone like himself and, you know, SNL alumni like Leslie Jones and Fred Armisen on set, how much improv do you get to do? Does it get a bit wild?
Yeah, we can certainly do improv. It's recommended. But you can only do it with people that can do it, you know, yeah, because we don't have a whole lot of time. So, but yeah, that's where you get the real magic. So, yeah.
I don't imagine. You jumped on a ship in Sydney Harbour yesterday.
Yes.
How was that?
Outrageous. I mean, who knows?
First time in the water?
No, just because of the weather. I was like, are we really going to go out on a boat? But we managed to, just for like 20 minutes, to get some good pics. And, yeah, it all came back to me. Sailing.
Oh, look at you there. Now, we have to talk about Flight of the Conchords. Do you think we'll ever see...
We do?
Yeah, we do. Even you were laughing.
I've got a new show.
We just showed. I know, but we have to just have remedies for a second. Do you think we'd ever see a reboot of it?
Who knows?
Would you be up for it?
Of course, of course. You know, it's a great show. But we can't live in nostalgia our whole lives. We've got to move on with new projects. And I think this new one is going to make everyone who is into the Conchords happy again.
Yeah, we absolutely love the Conchords. Obviously, it brought you across to the Hollywood as well. And I'd imagine as a comedian, it would be great to associate it with Robin Williams. And then obviously coming into Jumanji. And then he's done a second Jumanji. Could we see that comeback? Maybe Nigel?
The Jumanjis? Oh, yeah. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if they did another one. They're very successful and they fit into that realm of the very few family movies that both kids and adults can go to and enjoy at the same time. So... That aren't animation.
That aren't animation,
which,
yeah.
Which there isn't many, yeah. So hopefully it comes back.
Who of those co-stars would you leave in the game? The Rock, Jack Black, or Kevin Hart?
To leave in Jumanji?
To leave in the game, yeah. You'd imagine it's a lot of fun, but I'm sure it can be quite annoying also.
Look, I'm a big fan of Dwayne Johnson.
Yeah.
I think he would survive the game, and he's genuinely a nice guy. Of course, I love Jack Black. He's a comedian, so him and I got on really, really well. Not sure whether he'd survive the game.
Speaking of comedians, what was it like starting with Hollywood heavyweight Jim Carrey in your first Hollywood movie? Yes, Man. I absolutely love that movie.
It was surreal,
yeah,
because he was my idol. And I thought maybe one day I might get to meet him. But that was my first movie and I'm acting alongside him. So I just had to pinch myself every day. But he was so lovely with me and I was doing what I do best, which is comedy. And he had my back, so... Yeah, it worked out. I still look at it now and think, it looks like I've been photoshopped into that movie.
Not at all. You're fantastic. And I'm really excited about this new series on HBO. How much fun was it to film?
Amazing. So we had a great cast, wonderful writing, and we're all in this together. People came over from the UK. Most of the cast were British. We had Irish as well. And it was just an adventure. We took every day not for granted, because we knew it was a special time. We're dressing up as pirates and having a laugh during a pandemic. So we took it serious. And when I say that, you know, we had a blast.
Yeah. And Tiger is co-starring in it as well. He plays Blackbeard.
Yeah.
As well as directing the pilot episode. How much does that help, having someone you know so well, you've worked with before?
It's the best. I mean, without it, you're kind of floating on your own. And having him there to support me was everything, because this was my first big lead role in a TV series. And I had a lot of words to learn. I was in most of the scenes. And just knowing that he was there supporting me, it made me feel comfortable. So we support each other, and I do a lot of his projects because he wants me there to raise the spirits.
You're so amazing.
Yeah, it had to be that way.
But I'd imagine the comfort of having a fellow Kiwi there as well.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there's a certain way we do things on set, the way he controls the crew, and he is the overall ship captain of the whole project when he's directing. And the energy he brings, it's a special, unique thing I think can only be seen from New Zealanders.
That's it. I'm really excited about this new episode. If you want to
catch one, get away.
That's it. If you want to catch Rhys Darby as the gentleman pirate, Our Flag Means Death premieres tomorrow on Binge with a triple episode premiere. Thanks so much for joining us today. It really was a pleasure to speak to you. I'm a huge fan.
Oh, nice to see you guys
too.
Thank you.